Bring in now Samantha Holvey. She was Miss North Carolina in 2006, who competed in the Miss USA pageant. Samantha, thank you for coming on. You were Miss North Carolina USA. That was 2006. Describe your experience at the Miss USA pageant.
It was a very long experience. We were there for about a month. We traveled throughout Maryland, and we also did a media tour into New York City.
Mm-hmm. Now, I want you to listen to what Donald Trump told Howard Stern. This was back in 2005.
I'll go backstage before a show.
Yes.
And everyone's getting dressed and ready and everything else. And, you know, no men are anywhere. And I'm allowed to go in because I'm the owner of the pageant, and therefore I'm inspecting it. You know, I'm inspecting.
Right,
I want to make sure that
you're like
everything
a doctor.
Is good.
You're there.
Yeah, the dresses. Is everyone okay? You know, they're standing there with no clothes. Is everybody okay? And you see these incredible-looking women. And so I sort of get away with things like that.
So is this at all what you experienced?
Yeah, he summed it up exactly as I experienced. I was backstage in the hair and makeup area that you have to walk through before going into the dressing room. Luckily, I was in a robe, but this was before finals night. We have 51 beautiful girls from all over the country getting ready, all stages of getting ready. And he comes walking in, and I remember feeling so shocked and how inappropriate it was, because I was barely 20 years old. And here he comes into the dressing room and backstage, and I just felt that it was extremely inappropriate.
Mm-hmm. Did it ever make you, you know, rethink competing?
There had been previous experiences through my month at competing for Miss USA that made me realize that I loved my job as Miss North Carolina USA, and I wasn't looking to become Miss USA. It wasn't what I thought it was going to be.
Mm-hmm. Is it normal to see men in dressing rooms at pageants and the owner of the pageant?
No. No. The director of the North Carolina, South Carolina, Louisiana, and Alabama pageants, it's very much a family atmosphere. She doesn't even go backstage when the girls are getting ready. Only the female chaperones are allowed backstage in the dressing rooms with the girls. I've never had an experience where there were men or directors or anything like that walking back in the dressing rooms.
Yeah. As I understand, there, you have an experience of something that happened the night before the pageant?
Well, not the night before the pageant, but when we were in New York City on the media tour, they were doing a book launch at Trump Towers for the Universal Beauty book, and they had a bunch of former Miss USAs and Miss Universes and all 51 of us, and we did the red carpet, and that was tons of fun. And then they lined us all up, and Trump went down the line, and he shook your hand and, you know, looked you over, looked you up and down, head to toe, and was just checking everybody out.
And you thought, you felt?
I felt very dirty. It was very creepy. It's kind of like when you're at a bar and a creepy guy is checking you out. That was the experience for me.
So you've heard the Trump supporters and the defense. Mm-hmm. Why now? The credibility is gone because no one spoke out sooner. Why are you speaking out now?
Well, this is the first time that y'all have asked me. All of my friends and family, they know my experience. Anybody that's ever asked me about my experience, I've been happy to share it with them. This is the first time anybody's ever asked. And honestly, I was 20 years old, and what am I going to do, make a fuss because an old guy made me feel creepy?
Mm-hmm. Do you think some of the people are worried about maybe a legal recourse or something? Or?
Yeah, I mean, he definitely likes to throw lawsuits around. I was just honestly looking forward to getting back to North Carolina and enjoying the rest of my years, Miss North Carolina USA.
Samantha, thank you for coming on. I appreciate it.
You're welcome.
Thank you. Straight ahead.